Oh, can you hear us all right?
Yeah. Let me get a mic check right here so I can make sure we're not going overboard or anything. Please just say anything.
Check, mic check.
There it is, beautiful. All right, so who are we talking with right now?
This is Geoff, and I play guitar and sing in the Expendables.
Awesome, and you here with Adam?
Adam, and I drum and sing in the Expendables.
Sweet, so where are you guys at right now?
We are in Atlanta, Georgia.
In the Dirty South?
Dirty. Yeah.
How's that doing, you guys?
All right, man.
I'm there right now. OPM's killing it on stage, and Revolution's about to go on.
Hell yes. Let's start from the beginning. So, where are your musical roots from? I mean, like, where do you influence? I mean, like...
Basically, we were kids in high school into music, and we were into everything. Blues, surf, rock, even a little jazz, Geoff. Right?
Ska, reggae,
yeah, everything. So, when we started the band, we kind of decided to play everything, and that kind of made us who we are today.
If you were, it's really hard for me when I try to tell people about, you know, this different genre, you know, like the sublime, slightly stupid type stuff. What kind of genre, like, if you had one word for it, what would you call it?
That's the biggest problem we have with trying to tell, you know, we have no genre. It's everything. I kind of call it California music, kind of, but that's not really true either. I don't know. There's no name for it, so.
Yeah,
In Japan, our CD is under the mixture rock.
Mixture rock?
Mixture rock category.
All right, that's pretty good. I mean, I try to tell people it's ska, but it really isn't, you know?
Yeah, not really anything. It's kind of just...
Yeah, totally. Yeah. So, on this tour, guys got any crazy stories, or what was your best tour stop or anything like that?
Tucson. Arizona was awesome. Just
you guys
killer, sold out show, good times.
Yeah, man. You guys go to the U of A right over there, or...?
It was a bar right close to there, I believe.
Nice. Next question. Can you describe what kind of the creative process you guys go through when you're making a song? I mean, for like a new album or something?
It's really not really like a process we think about or like that we follow. It's just we bring ideas to the practice room and jam it out.
Just
really.
Jam it?
You know, yeah.
Hell yes.
Whoever it is will bring either a riff or a song or a part of a song or a chorus or a hook or
like Geoff wrote a song the other day on tour and we just played it during soundcheck and we're jamming it out that way. It's always different.
Yeah.
Never the same way twice pretty much.
Like we can play the whole song all the way through but I can't sing it because I don't know all the lyrics.
It's kind of a process like that, like whatever works, really.
Totally. Do you guys, like, go through some times where you just jam it and you put out, like, four or five songs at a time? Or
Right now, like, there's usually, like, after an album, we're not writing as much because the writing process is done.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, we're kind of getting ready to do another album.
Cool.
Within the year, so we're trying to get as many songs as we can for that album, so we're writing constantly. It's on the back of all of our minds right now.
Yeah, I was looking up on YouTube, and I saw, a collaboration with Kyle from Slightly Stupid. You guys have anything else like that or anything big coming up?
This next album, we kind of want to see if we can get some different guest people. We don't know who, but...
Yeah.
People from the same family of music.
Totally. I mean, I saw that and it was just the most disgusting like one-minute YouTube video I've ever seen, but... Yeah, totally. And, go.
He just... watched us play one time and he wanted to basically throw a verse out there and every time we play with him in the last couple months he's come up and sang with us.
Yeah, so how is it being under Slightly Stupid Records? How's that like?
Pretty cool. I mean like they've been our mentors, right? With?
Yeah, kind of.
They've been basically our who we looked up to when we started and then we kind of became we became friends, so
yeah, totally.
It works out really well.
It's a good relationship, label to artist relationship. There's nothing like weird or we don't hate the label because they take all of our money or anything like that. It's just like our buddies helping us out put out a record, really.
That's sick. Yeah, what was I gonna say? A question for Adam. I saw you on YouTube playing the banjo. Is there any future in that for you?
Well, I was a professional banjo player probably about 10 years before I joined the band.
Really? Sick.
No, absolutely not. I'd never played it before in my life. I had never even looked at one before. I just saw it, and I was kind of hungover and was like, hey, this might make me feel better.
I mean, you sounded pretty good on it, I gotta say.
I can kind of half-assedly play guitar, but kind of, not really. So I was just fucking around.
Totally.
Yeah, everything he's saying is a lie. He's really good at every instrument.
No, for real though, I've never played the banjo and I probably never will again, but that was just for fun, you know?
Alright, cool. And, I got a question. I saw you guys live up in Lawrence, Kansas, a year ago of your summer tour towards the end, and I saw that you guys have like a million pedals up front. Is that, how does that work for you guys?
That's actually Raul.
Raul?
He's the pedal master.
Oh, yeah?
He just got a brand new pedal board. I wish he was here to tell you about it, but...
Oh, sweet, man. All I know is just, like, at the beginning of Tight Squeeze, you know, I heard that. I thought it was just some sort of, you know, sound that you guys made in the studio. Someone just, you know, put it in. But it's actually a pedal noise. It's the most ridiculous thing ever.
All those weird noises. Like, that's kind of part of his deal.
He's a wizard.
Yeah,
kind of why we don't really have a keyboardist player, because he does all the weird... He's a wizard. That's right. He's a wizard.
You always need one of those in every band.
Yeah. And Geoff now has like fucking six pedals too. So I guess we're really pedal happy.
Hell yes. Hell yes. So I got one question. Like, do you ever see any of you guys like Slightly Stupid or anything? You guys making it big? Like, making it mainstream or something?
Yeah, they play our video on MTV every day.
Really?
No. We don't have a video. We're not big. We're small to medium sized band.
Do you think
basically we're underground, I believe, and it's kind of fun to be underground because, I don't know, mainstream music kind of sucks, so
yeah, but
it's good not to be labeled, you know.
Yeah. The mainstream does give you extra groupies, though.
I guess that would work out, but I'd rather play good music than shitty music, you know.
Hell yes. Like,
and have the fans really like us for what we're doing, not like the awesome marketing that's being thrown at them.
Well, definitely. I mean, when I saw you guys in concert, it's definitely by far the best concert I've ever seen in my life.
Thank you.
And but one thing that I found really interesting about you guys, you're really accessible. How do you guys feel? Like, you guys go out your way. I mean, I got like a poster signed from you. Like, is that something you guys try to do? Or?
Oh yeah,
yeah. Because it's no reason. I don't know.
That's kind of part of being in the underground thing.
Right.
Is like, you're just like anybody else, and you know, the audience. We go to shows too, and we're like. Those people on MTV and all that shit, you can't get an autograph or anything, get the stand lines and all that shit. We just kind of hang out our fan friends, kind of, you know?
Yeah.
That's sweet.
That's the best part about it all.
That's sweet. And so, here another question. You guys have that song, Ganja Smuggling. What was your inspiration for kind of covering that? You just heard it and you want to do it, or what?
Yeah, it was from a long time ago. Like, I don't know. I think Eka Mouse, for me, was one of the first reggae artists I ever seen live. So once I saw that song live, I thought it was a cool song anyway. And once we saw it live,
how were you able to figure out those words at the beginning?
I didn't.
Just made that up.
Just saying, I don't know what he says. I just make up sounds like the way I think it sounds on his album.
Sweet, sweet. So going back to the tour, what kind of living situations do you guys have? You guys got like a bus or a van or what's going on?
We travel in a recreational vehicle.
Yeah. We're in an RV right now, chilling. I mean, we were in a van for fucking ever, and we decided to step it up to an RV.
Nice.
But
living the high life.
Gas prices and all that shit make it so a bus is real hard to get.
All right, totally.
We're doing all right. We're having fun.